you could get carried away, and then you got to step back and say, hey, you know, some of this might be covered by flowers or something.
Yeah, it's important not to get lost in the details.
Hello, everyone. Good morning. Paul Trani here with the one and only Sasha Vinogradova. How are you doing, Sasha?
I am doing fantastic. Hi, Paul.
Yay. Great. Good to hear. I'm so happy that you're here. Very few people do I like ask to host. And I'm like, oh, Sasha's on. Like, let me host her and talk to her because she's an awesome designer. So give her a warm welcome.
I found an awesome, awesome photo. And that pretty much sparked a concept idea. I created a new composition. I brought the sketch I did earlier. And I brought the image I liked very much. I keep it as the smart object for now. And what I want to do here, I want to remove the bra. So we know we have just a bare skin, and I'll add some lines later to it. If you need to remove one object from the photo, I really like using either ContentAware Fill or a stamp tool. So what's interesting with ContentAware, if you try to do it like this.
And you're on that bottom layer. Boom.
Yes.
Never mind.
I'm just checking.
Oh yeah, perfect. This looks great. Continue. Sorry.
You can see the result. So what we need, we just need to select bra, which I'm going to do in a very rough way. Nothing crazy. My beautiful tracing skills.
This is exactly what I would do. Like.
And let's see. And with shift, I'm adding some selections. I can go to ContentAware Fill and see the result. Okay, so here you go. What's important with the ContentAware, you see how here you pretty much have this line and you still see what's happening? It's because I didn't grab enough of that shadow and I just need to extend my selection a little bit in those places.
And I know you just hopped out of that interface, but also from within that ContentAware Fill interface, you can go in and add and remove.
Oh, see, that's why I like when Paul hosts those things. I learn new things. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so file, content.
And this is new, by the way. This whole ContentAware Fill interface is fairly new, so. But yeah, that looks good. So you can see Sasha on the left side. See how there's a lasso tool and a brush?
Oh, so right up there,
click on that. And then you can like select, you should be able to select a little bit more in the green.
That is so cool. Love it.
There you go. And you see that live update?
Yeah.
Bam. Nice.
Learning Photoshop together.
Learning together. We're learning together, everybody. It's awesome.
Okay, here's another spot. Okay, and Photoshop did its magic. Amazing. I don't know how it's happening, but it's happening.
And okay. you could output, like there's a ton of other things we won't get into, but there's a lot it can do, like, but that's all. Okay, yeah, go ahead. You're outputting it to a new layer, which is awesome. So that'll be kind of on a separate layer, boom.
Yeah, it doesn't have to be, but.
Smoothing it out, I see, yeah.
Yep, just using a clone tool and grabbing some spots. And I think this is good. I'm just going to, I see a couple more places where I see the lines and I'm going to.
And I feel like sometimes with some of this, like you could get carried away and then you got to step back and say, hey, you know, some of this might be covered by flowers or something.
Yep.
So also like no. You probably know when to stop or what, at least what to cover up if there is a hard part. You're like, yeah, I'm going to cover that with a leaf.
Yeah, it's important not to get lost in the details. Otherwise, you'll burn yourself too soon and then it'll take you forever to do things. I'm going to show how to submerge objects under the water.
This is a beautiful image too that we're looking at now. Wow. Let's dive in if you're ready. This is exciting.
Yeah, we're literally going to be diving in. One thing which we're obviously missing is our distortion. And in order to do that distortion, I'm going to use Displace. And as you know, don't know, there is a filter.
I like how you, sorry, you continue. There we go. Yeah, do your thing.
Distort and Displace. This will ask you to use a different file. It will ask you the horizontal scale, vertical scale, amount of distortion, and it will ask you to use an external file. And what's happening, it takes that distort file, which will look like this, and I'm going to show you how I built it. Everything which is black going to be untouched, everything which is white going to be moved. So it's the map of distortion. So let me walk you through how I did this distortion thing. It's super, super simple. I created a comp, which is the same size as my sort comp. Then here you can see how it was building it. I'm using just a black layer, and then go to filter and render. And I used fibers. Yep.
Oh.
Yep. And from here, I adjusted the image I got.
Okay.
Convert it to a smart object.
Yeah. Taking notes.
Gaussian blur a little bit. Nothing crazy.
Blur it a little.
And let's come back to our references. As you can see, that's what we're trying to recreate. We're trying to recreate this distortion, which is the strongest, closest to the, you know, to the camera on top of the screen. And then obviously it goes away. So that's why I am using gradient. So.
To answer that earlier question, looks like your gradient tool set from black to transparent.
Yep.
So you could build up to what you want.
Yep.
So and, somebody asked that earlier. So.
Yeah, you can control your opacity on the in here, and your color is in here.
I feel like the smoother it is as you play with Gaussian, the better off you're going to be. Because if it's too rough, it really jacks with your displacement map, I feel. What do you think?
Yeah. I think if I will not use the Gaussian filter on it, it will be just very jaggedy. And, you know, waves are smooth. Mm-hmm. From here, I am going to, again, merge everything. Shift-Control-Alt-E. Then I'm going to flip my image vertically. Create mask.
So we're basically making a reflection of the sword on the top of the water, right?
Yep. Again, let's come back to the references. Here you can see how image being reflected but also distorted, and we will try to recreate it. And that's why before I delved into those reflections, I made sure that all the bubbles are there so we can reflect all of it.
Wow.
Okay, so from here, I'm merging everything again. Merge into smart object and filter, distort, displace. 300 and 150 were my settings. Let's see how it looks with the new distort map.
And I feel like those numbers you just have to play with.
Yep. So
okay,
that is our result. I'm grabbing this and I'm just going to distort it.
I kind of like it when that reflection touches the top of the sword, so you know it's like connected.
Yeah, that would be cool.
But I'm not the art director.
Hey, let's do
that. You're the art director.
Well, Paul, today you are directing, so deal with that.
This is the peanut gallery. It's worked so much better than like, there's other distortion tools. Like if you go into filter under distort, there's things called wave and zigzag. You know, all those.
Yeah, I tried those, and my problem with that was it was just I couldn't find nice horizontal look which would fade. So pick something with the matching lighting, something ideally top down lighting, or maybe 45 degrees lighting. Could be any other object.
That looks amazing. Can't say enough kind words about you as a person, and of course you as an exceptional artist and
people designer. Thank you so much for having me.